Guys, welcome to my channel. I'm here to fulfill a promise I made you a while ago. I made a flip through my first Halloween scrapbook, and I promised to show you the second one. The first one was a Project Life type, and now I'm going to show you my second one that starts with the 2012 pictures. And let's get into it. This first page, I haven't seen this album in a long time, so it's going to be like new for me. So forgive me for my mistakes, and maybe I will go back and forth. But well, let's start. This page, this image and this image are transparencies. I found those images on internet, and I printed them out with my computer on transparency paper that you can buy on Amazon or eBay. And they are great to add to pages that are solid background. I distress the pictures with a special scissors, and then added some embellishments. This one. This is also a transparency. That whole tree with the owl and the bats are printed separately. And I added the ribbon and some other embellishments. As you can see, I add a lot of pictures as usual, as I show you in other videos with tutorials on how to add a lot of pictures to one layout, because I take a lot of pictures for every holiday, trip, event, and then I can't delete any of them, so I have to come out with ideas to add a lot of them on each page. Here, well, we have distressed paper, and what else? Everything is, yes, there is nothing that I printed out with my computer, so nothing special to mention. In this case, I love these borders, are from K&C company. I think they are discontinued now, but I love them. I used this paper that I added to the background, which was solid, and I made myself this banner, and I had these letters or stickers. One of them is not okay now, much better. This one is printed by me with my computer, this card. All of the other stuff are regular stickers and embellishments. This one, I found a seller on eBay. She makes a lot of nice stuff, and I always buy from her this kind of stuff, like the tree, the fence, because I don't have any machine and I don't want one, because maybe I could afford the machine, but then you have to buy the cartridge, and no, not me. It's too expensive for me. So whenever I need something, I just go to eBay and I buy, mainly from this seller, this kind of stuff. In this case, I use layers. Let me tell you, layers are a must when you are scrapbooking. They give any layout such a good look, and it's so easy. And then you can use all those little bits and pieces of paper that you have around, and very, very quickly you can decorate a page. That I do that very often. One detail, these bobby pins. You can see them here. I bought them from Family Dollar. They are really, really, really cheap. I don't know how many. They come in a bag of, I I think I paid like $2 for a bag of a lot of them. I made these banners with pieces of scrap paper, and well, I added these stickers. They are from Dollar Tree, but they don't have them anymore. Remember, this is our 2012 Halloween, so many months ago. In this case, I added this half circle, again, trying to use pieces of paper that I had left over from other projects. Another thing that add a real good look to pages are corners, and larger ones, very large ones. And that's what I did here and here. I have a special scissor for the borders of this, the large one in black, the larger one. And then again, layers. This is a special scissor. This is another special scissor. Pieces of paper. Another piece of paper. And just gluing layers and pieces of scrapbooking paper, you have a layout in just a few minutes. In this case, I have corners again here and here with brads, and I distress the borders of these papers. Again, matting papers, layers are for me the best way to make a layout quickly, and especially when it's a 12x12 page, sometimes it's really hard to fill a page, and this is, for me, is the best way. Special scissors, torn paper. I couldn't remember the word, sorry for silence. Ribbon. I have a punch that makes this spider web. My God, what's going on with me? I have just one brain cell and it's not working. And I added a little dot of glue gun, of glue with my glue gun, to give it a 3D effect. In this case, we always go to a special event in one pedestrian street in our town, and I take pictures of the kids that they are always dressed in beautiful costumes, and they are very really cute. And I fussy cut them, the pictures, and added them to these pieces of paper. This is a 12x12 page that I glued to a black paper to make it stand out. And again, pictures. I like to place the pictures with a matting paper and twist them a little bit. I think they look really great. I added ribbons, eyelets for the ribbons here. Again, this is another border that comes in the package with the other one that I showed you before from K&C Company. It's so sad that they don't do them anymore. I found these tombstones on the internet and I printed them because I thought they were great to place pictures on each of them. Of the people, you know, in that street, you have two kind of events in the same day. From 5 p.m. till around 8 p.m., you can see the kids. But after that, the crazy thing starts to happen, and you can see a lot of stuff that you don't see when the kids are around. more people in the streets. I love graphic 45 papers. So I print, this is printed out by me. This is a 12 by 12 page, sorry, that I resized to make this smaller kind of card. All of this is printed by me. This frame has been also printed by me, along with this one. Okay, this is 2013. For that Halloween, we decided to get dressed as Snow White and her stepmother, the Evil Queen. So we went to the street that we always go, as I said, dressed this way, and we never imagined how much people would like our costumes. Everybody wanted a picture with us. As you can see again, layers and layers and tags, one on top of the other, hidden, and again with the special scissors, I distress this paper that I adhere on top of the other one. I also distress the matting paper. One thing I do is I use cards, Christmas cards, birthday cards, and in this case Halloween cards. And when I like them so much that I don't want to part with them, I use them as booklets on my scrapbooks, sorry. And here you have more pictures. This is a ribbon that I bought at Dollar Tree. It's wired, and I thought it's a perfect addition. This was some twine that I had around the house. And again, I added this paper. I printed this border. Again, corners. This is a page with pictures of our house decor for Halloween. Again, tons of different papers. You hear? You see here? This border, I have a stencil to do this. It has a lot of different stitches. This is one of them. This is another thing that I do. These are mini notebooks from Dollar Tree. And what I do is I adhere pictures to each white page inside the notebook. This is printed by me. Again, another one printed by me. Well, all of them are printed by me. Yes, all of them. There are no originals here. So I can have a lot of pictures. It has a magnet. I added this spider web to make it more Halloween-y. Another border that I love and I can't get it anymore. It's been discontinued. I use this kind of gauze as a spider web. Here you can see a lot of pictures again of the same street the following year, 2012-2013. And I added these stitches with the tool that I already showed you in my video about the tools I can't live without. You can go there and find the tool. More people. Rick-rack. Rick-rack is a great addition, especially for Halloween because of the shape. It makes it it complements the page well, in my opinion. Corners, matting papers, pieces of scrapbooking paper in layers, special scissors border. And again, to add more pictures. I had this envelope. I don't remember. My Mind's Eyes is the company that makes it, but I don't remember if it was part of a kit or what. So I place a lot of pictures in this kind of pocket. And, well, what's going on? It got stuck. Here it goes. In this case, I use 3 background papers. I distressed 2 of them. I added another of the borders that comes in that collection. All of these embellishments had been printed by me, as well as this one. I added the spider web sticker to the O, because I was able to place at the other O, not covering the spider, so I thought the web was perfect place there. Here, pictures of my decor, my home decor, and we start with 2014. I made this banner with little pieces of scrapbooking paper. I decorated the border of this card, and this is a sticker that I added. It's a piece of scrapbooking paper, another piece of scrapbooking paper. In this case, these spider webs, they are from treat bags. You know those treat bags for the candies? Well, this was not my idea. I saw this idea from another scrapbooker and I thought this is great. So I was able to find the bags and I could cut the spider webs with the spiders and place it on the background. Again, I used this mesh, this gauze. Another kind of mini album to add more pictures. Showing our home decor. Again, the goth. You see, the goth is perfect as a spider web. I love how it looks. And I added glitter to the spiders because they were just black. Again, I used 2 different papers and a doily. I happened to find black doilies, which is not easy. And the fence is from that seller I told you on eBay. I folded this corner to add this little spiderweb here sticker. In this case, I added this paper that is an 6x6 page, and I used it to frame these pictures. I added this corner that is from another 12x12 page, and then I added the pictures with the matting papers. You know, I just tore the papers, and I added this border. Again, this is from the treat bag. In this case, the spider was purple, and the background paper was so well decorated that I didn't need to do a lot of stuff, just added the pictures and a few embellishments. I made this banner also, and I did the stickers. I have two more of these embellishments, but I don't know. I think I'm going to use them in some decor for the house because it's really heavy, really bulky, so it's hard to place it in an album. So I use this one, but I love how it looks, but I think that it's not great for a scrapbook. Again, different borders, different papers. Two different scrapbooking papers here, some corners, a lot of pictures and other stickers. Sorry for the glare, I didn't notice it was a lot of glare. Sorry. It's hard. I hope you see it anyways. Again, from the treat bags, another border. I printed this one with my computer. These are those cupcake liners that I cut and mash them. Again, I distress the borders with the scissors. This is also background paper that was so pretty that I just added the pictures and a couple of embellishments, some washi tape here and here, because it didn't need anything else. And I added some rhinestones, and that was it. And here, I'm trying to avoid the glare, but it's really hard, sorry. Again, three different background papers. Another ribbon that I bought at Dollar Tree. Matting papers, distressed with special scissors. I printed out all this. Well, this not, this was a little bit of scrapbooking paper. But I printed out this and this and this embellishment, yeah, cards and stuff. And the last page, I used this paper that is from a Halloween collection, but I added these snowflakes, and I have the stamp that I use. It comes inked in blue, so I use it in the background to give it a more wintry look. I even went on the pictures because it's frozen costume, so I needed to mix both things. I added this spider web and these spiders with rhinestones that I added, so I mixed both themes together. This is the real tiara that I'm wearing in the pictures. And well, that's my whole album. I hope you can use some ideas as inspiration. I do that all the time. I go around looking at other people's layouts to get inspired. Oh, I'm seeing, sorry. This is something I wanted to show you. I use this tabs that comes with bread and other packages, and I think they are great additions to layouts, with a little bit of piece of ribbon and some letters. Okay, let's go back to where we were. Again, I hope you like this video, this album, and if so, please like this video and subscribe, and hope to see you in my next video. As usual, thank you so much for watching. You have no idea what it means to me. Have a great, great day, and see you soon. Bye-bye.